Hello and welcome to Learn Something New, the channel where we explore fascinating topics from around the world. I'm your host, and today we are going to take you on a journey to one of the most amazing archaeological sites in Egypt, the Valley of the Kings. The Valley of the Kings is a long narrow valley on the west bank of the Nile River, near the ancient city of Thebes, or modern-day Luxor. It was the burial site of almost all the kings, or pharaohs, of the 18th, 19th, and 20th dynasties, as well as some queens, high priests, and other elites. These dynasties ruled Egypt during the New Kingdom period, from about 1550 to 1075 BC, when Egypt was at the height of its power and glory. The valley contains over 60 tombs that have been discovered so far, and some more that are still hidden or unfinished. The tombs are not just simple holes in the ground, they are elaborate underground structures with chambers, corridors, paintings, sculptures, and treasures. The tombs were designed to protect the mummies and belongings of the pharaohs for their journey to the afterlife, where they hoped to join the gods. But why did they choose this valley for their burial place? Well, there are several reasons. First of all, the valley is located on the west side of the Nile, which was associated with death and rebirth in ancient Egyptian beliefs. The sun god Ra would set in the west every evening and rise in the east every morning, symbolizing his cycle of death and resurrection. The pharaohs wanted to follow his example and be reborn in the next world. Secondly, the valley is surrounded by cliffs that form a natural pyramid shape. The pyramid was also a symbol of eternal life for the ancient Egyptians, as it represented the primordial mound that emerged from the waters of chaos at the beginning of creation. The pharaohs of the Old and Middle Kingdoms built huge pyramids for their tombs, but they were often robbed and vandalized by thieves. The New Kingdom pharaohs decided to hide their tombs in a secret valley under a natural pyramid instead. Thirdly, the valley was sacred to a goddess named Hathor, who was known as the Mistress of the West. Hathor was a goddess of love, beauty, music, and motherhood, but she also had a funerary aspect. She welcomed the souls of the dead into her realm and helped them cross over to the afterlife. She was often depicted as a cow or a woman with cow horns. The pharaohs wanted to be under her protection and favor when they died. So how did they build these magnificent tombs? Well, it was not an easy task. It took years of planning, engineering, and labor to carve out these underground palaces. The pharaohs would start preparing their tombs as soon as they ascended to the throne, sometimes even before. They would appoint a team of architects, artists, priests, and workers to oversee the project. They would also choose a location in the valley that suited their preferences and personality. The workers would dig into the rock using copper tools, wooden levers, ropes, baskets, and sandbags. They would remove tons of debris and transport it away from the site. They would also create ventilation shafts and drainage channels to prevent flooding and suffocation. They would smooth out the walls and ceilings and decorate them with colorful paintings and carvings depicting scenes from the life of the pharaoh, his achievements, his religious beliefs, and his hopes for the afterlife. The artists would use natural pigments made from minerals, plants, and animal products to create vivid colors that have lasted for thousands of years. They would follow strict rules and conventions for representing figures and symbols according to their meaning and importance. They would also write hieroglyphs, or sacred signs, that told stories and spells to help guide and protect the pharaoh in his journey. The priests would perform rituals and ceremonies to consecrate the tomb and prepare it for receiving the body of the pharaoh. They would also place various objects inside the tomb that were meant to serve the pharaoh in his next life. These objects included furniture, clothes, jewelry, weapons, games, food, drink, and even pets. Some of these objects were real, while others were models or replicas. The most important object was the sarcophagus, or stone coffin, that contained the mummy of the pharaoh. The mummy was the preserved body of the pharaoh that had been treated with special chemicals and wrapped in linen bandages. The mummy was the vessel for the soul of the pharaoh that would travel to the afterlife and reunite with the gods. The most famous and spectacular tomb in the valley is that of Tutankhamun, or King Tut, who ruled Egypt for a short time in the 14th century BC. His tomb was discovered in 1922 by a British archaeologist named Howard Carter, who was amazed by the wealth and beauty of the treasures he found inside. Among them was the famous golden mask that covered the face of the mummy, as well as other gold and silver objects, precious stones, statues, chariots, and even a throne. The tomb of Tutankhamun is one of the few tombs that was not completely robbed or damaged by ancient or modern looters, and it gives us a glimpse of how the other tombs might have looked like when they were intact. But Tutankhamun is not the only pharaoh who lies in the valley. There are many other tombs that belong to some of the most powerful and influential rulers of ancient Egypt, such as Thutmose III, Hatshepsut, Amenhotep III, Akhente, Ramses II, and Seti I. Each tomb has its own unique features and characteristics that reflect the personality and style of its owner. Some tombs are large and complex, with multiple chambers and corridors. Some tombs are small and simple, with only one or two rooms. Some tombs are decorated with bright and cheerful colors, while others are dark and gloomy. Some tombs have elaborate paintings and carvings, while others have plain walls and ceilings. Some tombs have religious and mythological themes, while others have historical and autobiographical themes. The Valley of the Kings is a fascinating place to visit and explore. It is a place where history, art, religion, and mystery come together to create a unique and unforgettable experience. It is a place where you can learn something new about the ancient Egyptians and their culture, beliefs, and achievements. It is a place where you can admire the skill and creativity of the people who built these tombs and decorated them with such beauty and detail. It is a place where you can feel the presence and power of the pharaohs who once ruled this land and left behind their legacy for us to discover. Thank you for watching this episode of Learn Something New. I hope you enjoyed it and learned something new. If you did, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And don't forget to check out our website for more information and resources about the topics we cover. Until next time, stay curious and keep learning. In the next episode of Learn Something New, we will take you to another amazing archaeological site in Egypt, the Valley of the Queens. This is where the wives and children of the pharaohs were buried, along with some other royal and noble women. The Valley of the Queens has over 80 tombs that are similar to those in the Valley of the Kings, but smaller and less elaborate. However, they still have some stunning paintings and carvings that show us the beauty and diversity of ancient Egyptian women. Stay tuned for more.